I've booked a month. I'm going to take this one slowly and easily, working on it with Paul Stacey, with his extraordinary collection of amps and guitars and keyboards. I'm hoping to wrap up recording the end of January, then do the orchestral and choir session in February, and be mixing through February, early March, and have the album finished by March. That's my plan.
Sounds really naff, but could you roll around the drum like the toms a little bit, just a little bit?
Yeah, man.
Okay, mate. Come and have a listen to that and see what you think.
And you're done.
In a couple of weeks, we'll have the drum sound.
Hi, Craig. Sorry I'm late, mate.
Hey, sorry.
Just haven't got that sort of sizzling top end, which... That just sounds a little bit more punk rock, if you like.
Yeah.
Let's do the amp as well.
Yeah, I think I need to hear it with a bit
of... Yeah, sure. Can
we
just grab the
rhythm tape? Okay.
Fucking hell.
Just like really old vintage snare drums and stuff.
Tank is a 28-inch Slingerland Radio King.
Wow.
Some amazing, amazing vintage stuff.
Well, I have got lots of mics up at the moment. You've got lots of options, but I think it sounds pretty good.
It sounds good.
Yeah. I don't know if it's right yet, but we'll see.
Let's
find
out.
I might actually, when you're doing the I might actually try playing eighths on the bass as well, rather than just going it might sound like a load of wank, but
okay,
I might try it anyway.
It's coming together. I think that'd be great.
Yeah, no, the sound's getting better as well, which is good.
How's the snare?
Snare sounds good.
Raised is amazing.
Yeah.
I think we'll just do a load of interviews. I was thinking of all the tracks now of what we can use, like the 400 for Pariah.
Like a track like this, I don't want to have to add too much.
That's quite tight, isn't it?
Yeah, Pariah. So the sound is so critical.
Yeah.
It's just kind of stopping me, just won't stop, you know. It's got every little detail. Every little detail.
Click might be nice, Paul. I mean, actually, it's not so important.
Good
better if I had the click.
All right.
Just for the, just not so much for when the drum machine comes in, but a bit before that, ready. Just in the back. None of that shit. No, but you know, but just just like break up the patterns a bit more.
Okay, mate. Yeah.
I know.
Yeah. No.
After you've done it, I might say no, go back and do it the way you were. But yeah. I just it'd be nice to try it. Both guitar players, both very good guitar players.
Yes.
Daniel Steinhardt, who runs Gig Rig, and Nigel Spennyman is a very old, good old friend of both of us. I used to be in a band with Nigel 30 years ago. Christ, I feel old now.
I used to work in the same guitar shop as him.
Right. And they've both been saying to me for at least the last 3 or 4 years, you should work with Paul. And I kind of, first few years I said yeah whatever, and then this time around I went out for dinner with Nigel and he said to me again, you should really work with Paul. And I said suddenly thought to myself, actually, you know what, this album be great to have someone that can be like, you know, co-produce it with me. And he said he'll push you, and that was it for me. So the moment he said to me he will push you,
yeah,
I thought that's what I need.
Over the edge.
Well, you know, just someone that's just not going to let me do all the same old shit I do every time, you know, and
yeah.
Which, not that there's anything wrong with that, but I just wanted something, I wanted somebody that would push me and think about music in a different way. And so that was it. When he said that to me, I said, I should meet this guy. And then...
And that really is what a producer is, isn't it, really? It's somebody that you... Well, you have to get the trust together first, you know.
But honestly, I always thought I was unproducible. I always said to everyone, I'm unproducible.
Yes.
Because when Alan Parsons came on board to do an album for me a couple of albums ago, he said to me, you don't want me to produce you? And I said, no, I'm unproducible. And I really thought I was unproducible. But actually, I think it's all a question, like you say, if you trust that person and you respect their opinions.
And we did have discussions. I mean, that's the thing, beforehand, because obviously there wouldn't have been any point in doing it if you know, I wasn't going to be...
Well, there would have been. I mean, you'd still have done a great job recording everything.
Yes,
but,
yes.
But, you know, nice that it was more than that.
Yeah, no, that's right. But, I mean, the thing is you can see if it's going to go a certain way and it's just like, oh, this is going to go wrong quickly,
yeah.
You know. But we sort of figured that out. All beforehand. I must admit, you're not producible at all. It's just that, but what you've got is that you're very sure of what you like, which is actually a relief, because when somebody doesn't know what they want and you go around in circles and you still don't know what they want and they still don't know what they want, then you just don't want to do it, you know. I think
I have a certain sort of set of parameters. I know that everything has to be within this certain set of parameters, but within that there are lots of different ways to do it.
Yes.
And I think you kind of were able to sort of show me some of the other ways we could do that, you know, recording sure. guitars or, you know, using the Celine and all this stuff. And
yes.
and it was all stuff I kind of, instinctively liked anyway.
Yes.
But not necessarily things I'd actually done myself in my own music before.
Right.
And I think that that was the difference for me, yeah.
The way I've done the stems, Craig, is the guide drums are doing all the hi-hat stuff through the electronic sections as well.
Yeah, yeah.
But I want to take them out of the middle section and have you take over.
Oh, right, okay.
You'll still hear the 909 kick and the 808 snare stuff. Not the 808 snare, whatever it is.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But you won't hear any cymbal work there. So that's all going to be you.
Oh, right,
so
mate.
we just got to fix that.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Doing
E flat.
Yeah. So you got to, yeah, okay. You got to F sharp.
No, just
sorry,
C.
So that's E flat.
Oh, do you mean, are you talking about in the progression?
Sorry, I'll. That sounded good, Craig. I'm just working on something with Nick just for 2 seconds as well.
Are you talking about the actual middle section?
The very end section. So you're
just
going.
What
are the two notes? It's E.
It's just C and E.
Oh, C and E. Okay.
E flat rather.
Okay. Yes. So when you go up to the E flat, so you're going do 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 off. Can you do that every time?
Yeah.
Just to see what that does.
Yeah.
Yeah, we just keep lying and say it sounded great. All right, here we go, mate. It sounds fantastic.
Yeah.
Here we go. God, I'm not posting any of this shit. God, me being a twat.
The fact that he only did the tom fill once, yes. And quite late on in the song, where I might even have faded out, that was really good. We got that one, Paul. So you remember what your cunning plan is for later then?
I haven't done co-production much. Mm. I was working with Stephen as a solo artist, and he has his troupe, if you like, of people, which, you know, which we changed up a bit in places as well. We tried different things and different people, but. Mm. I suppose again it's everyone's different for me, because what you try and do as a producer is you come in at what you think's missing or what you think could be improved, and you know sometimes you're working on the psychological aspect more than anything and hardly on the music, and sometimes you're working on the sound, or sometimes you work, you know, it's like a bit like a film director, really, is that you're kind of overseeing the whole thing, you know. I mean, you as
you're
well,
making we, a record.
And you're, yeah, you're making, making a record. And you're making a record, you know, and you're yeah. You've overseen everything that you've done. So, joining with you and doing it without not, I don't really know so much about Steve beforehand, so. Yeah. So that was different, you know, but from...
I think that's because one of the first things you asked me is, what do you want me to do? And I said, I want you to make a record with me.
Yes.
And I think what you were asking me is, am I producer, am I engineer? And I'm like, I don't know. I want you to make a record with me and whatever it takes. And I think after a couple of weeks, I came to you and I said, look, obviously you are co-producing. And I wasn't sure until then how it was going to pan out. But
sure.
But it was just like, whatever it takes to make the best record.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
And like you say, sometimes it's to do with psychology, sometimes it's to do with sonic, sometimes it's to do with playing, and it's whatever it takes, you know, to make the record. Mm-hmm.
doing that.
Yes.
The
ending was really good. That time.
Yeah.
Yeah, that ending was great, actually, Jeremy. Listen, do you want to come in for a second? Is that all right?
Absolutely.
Or did you want to just bang another one?
Or use one of the endings we've already got, because we've got some great ones. Okay, well, let's do another one, yeah.
Okay.
See just if we can top it, but I think now you've got this innate, we're probably pretty covered.
On a side note, Paul, yes. The bass take was superb that time. I just want to tell you that the bass take...
Apparently the bass take was superb on that one.
I just wanted to mention how superb the bass was on that take.
It was.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, good. There we go.
I forgot to tell you that Jeremy had asked for you to be removed from his cans.
Okay. Well, he'll be sorry because he's missed that.
He's missed out. Yeah,
he's really missed out. There.
Here we go. Honestly, I can still hear him.
Okay.
Here we go.
6 feet on the ground, we move backwards now. At the speed of sound, we are nowhere now. Too much time to kill, too much wasted, too much everything. There's no need to think. Heat above the clouds, I am.
First thing about Nowhere Now is, you know, 6 feet underground, mm-hmm. We move backwards now. It's this idea that the human race is kind of in this state of devolution. You know, we're going backwards. Looking down from here, the earth is, you know, it's a beautiful thing. It's luminous, observed, and I'm away from all the crowds, and I'm above the clouds. And so it's this idea again that the verse is this fairly gloomy, you know, look at the way we you know, we are, look at the human race in the 21st century. I mean, the same asylum as before, that the whole idea of the title is, you know, it doesn't matter what kind of religion you look at, you're still stuck in the same madhouse. So again, it's this idea of religion being a very negative human trait, a very negative human impulse. And again, that taps then into the terrorist thing and the religion theme in songs like Detonation. So there are definitely strong I think themes, albeit that they are a bit more vague and they're a bit more universal and a bit more loose. That is very new for me. I don't know why. Maybe I just got fed up with being described as the most miserable bastard in the music industry.
Yeah, I think...
I was quite proud of that.
Perfect, keep that. So I can key you in for that.
Okay. It's a good start, I think. It's just slightly unbox it a little bit more.
When we first drop into that groove, I just want to feel a little bit more skippy.
Yeah.
A little bit
more
kinetic, you know?
Yeah. I think the snare should be the more I hear this, the more I'm thinking brighter, everything punchier, brighter.
Maybe.
To be honest, because it doesn't really, it's hard to really make this connect with it if it's sounding, I mean, I like the sound, but I just think it's...
Yeah, as soon as it was like, it became, as I said, it was just, it sounds slight, and I know what you mean, it's on this one.
But I mean,
there's no way you're going to be able to play it. soft.
Well, it's like even lighter. I don't think it's. As like as soon as I hear the demo drums, like it's much more attack and bright and.
Okay.
Do you know what I mean?
This feels a little bit roomy and distant to me.
Yeah, it does. Yeah. That's what I think. It needs a little bit, to be honest. But
so, let's change it up then.
Definitely, that's great. That was a really good one.
That was a great one.
Sorry, you kicked the DI off.
Did I?
So that's why the bass suddenly went away. Quiet, but it just in the end just went quiet. Jeremy. Yep.
Even though it wasn't perfect, I think I did some things in there.
Yeah.
That will cover the other.
Yeah, cover the other.
Yeah,
yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. That's great. We got a fucking.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No,
it'll be a killer. Yeah, that would be a killer thing.
We've got a killer track.
Nice one, man. Let's play the whole thing just quickly one more time for me. Yeah, that's good. Okay, I'm happy with that. I'm gonna go with that.
Yeah, let's do it. Fuck it. Pop music.
Fuck it, let's do it.
You ready, Rob? Should we do one?
Yeah.
We don't sound so enthusiastic. Fucking hell.
So you just play the E into that,
yeah,
and then just let it ring, but don't play until the track comes right back down to the verse again.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
Right. So it's just guitar.
I know that sounds like a weird thing to do, but that's kind of how I want it. I want that so it can really be weightless, and then yeah. Otherwise, it sounded great. Music.
Thank you.
Mm. I gotcha.
Da 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 da.
Annette says that sounds amazing.
Yeah.
Okay.
So there you go.
All right, crap.
So good.
It sounds so beautiful. So let me get Nanette in there now, and then we'll see if we can get them both to work together.
Han, you need the lyrics too, right?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I've got another music stand downstairs.
Should I bring your number?
Can you bring that book?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Of course.
I think I've got another music stand, amazingly enough. Shall I get it?
That would be great.
Okay.
So you use.
Ah, it's exciting!
Use that one, Han.
Okay.
And then I'll use my. I'll read my terrible handwriting.
You think you're thinking about it now a little bit.
Maybe.
So.
Or maybe you got it earlier, but would you want to try one more?
Yeah, no, I want to get it because it's like really close. Are you lighter than you would normally be, do you think?
What do you mean?
Like, are you hitting it? I almost want you to come in just a little harder.
Oh, I'm lighter, yeah, because I hear my vocal a bit.
Too loud.
Yeah.
Yes, that's what I was starting to think, is maybe now you're too loud, so
yes.
I kind of want you to sort of like, because
on
the demo it sounds just like you're going, ah! You're just like, you know, just going for it completely, and this is more considered, which I'd like to hear one without you being considered.
Okay.
If you like.
So you need to
turn your volume down a bit.
Yeah.
Turn your volume down a bit, okay. And Stephen, great. I think, again, just squeeze anything. Squeeze something.
Okay.
Emotionally,
yeah,
you know, because it was all there when you're not thinking about it.
And all the worn-out things that I ever said, now it's much too late. Words stay in my head.
Yes. That's a good one.
So the day will begin again. Take comfort from me. It's up to you now. You're still here and you're digging again. That's comfort to you. It's up to you now. So pariah, you'll begin again. Take comfort from me. And now I'll take comfort from you.
Come in.
Okay.
Okay.
Just to see how you feel where it's gone, but
yeah. Well, hopefully you got it now, right?
I've definitely got it.
Fucking amazing.
Yeah.
Both of you.
Well, if you think you got it, I think you might have to comp a bit, me. That's all for pitching stuff.
Unless yeah, maybe a little bit, but yeah, but not as much as you might think. As the right. One, as soon as you stop thinking about it, the right. The pitching was not even a question
yeah.
to me okay. anymore.
Nothing left for us. Nothing is left but the blank days in your car.
That's really good, Stephen.
It's not the sort of, not the sort of thing you want to sing too many times because it's
no, no, of
it's
course.
Supposed to sound a bit broken.
My performance is nowhere near as good as my demo, I don't think. That's some good stuff.
Was it?
Yeah.
I spent a long time on the demo. It's just getting the right, the emotion just.
Yeah, no, I don't
feel right.
All that I know is you'll be gone.
Just come to the door and
yeah.
then sort of go.
The first, yeah, what I was think the previous one you had?
That was the high watt.
And what's this one now?
This is the Kelly, which is my new favourite amp.
No, that'll be the thing, is they're all got a colour. This kind of sounds like the, what we want right at the start of the album, just to go.
Yeah.
We're
gonna do it. Yeah, it's great. Yeah. So we just try that and.
Let's
so just so
way.
You understand what
yeah.
I'm trying to do, and
yeah.
then I'm happy to go, you know, we, if we get a sound that we like, and I'll just say, all right, change telly. Let's go have another telly here.
Yeah.
I'll give you this one. Now double the part this side, so it's got a slightly different timbre, you know, and then it can sound really good.
Okay, well, let's do it your way, and then...
Then you can tell me to fuck off
and
after.
Then I'll tell you to fuck off. If it doesn't sound right to me, then I'll tell you, obviously. You know.
Sure.
Very much a comfortable feeling about
right.
what you're playing. If you're used to it, if it doesn't sound bad, I'm not going to get that anal about it.
Okay.
Just
whip it out. Jeremy's little fill in the middle of that
that's
verse.
Great.
So
that's great.
Great. Yeah.
That's really good. Sorry.
I was fucking just commit to it.
Oh,
it,
no, I'm, yeah. No,
it doesn't sound good, we won't use it. Oh, hello.
Proper. Oh, yeah.
Proper.
It's only proper here, mate. That fucking... girl shit.
Put it straight in if it works.
Shot and then maybe I think we should call it if that's all right.
Okay.
Is that okay? Just because
yeah.
I'm sort of
fading.
Fading.
I think you're definitely you're in the right area.
Yeah.
It's the right sort of balance between
being able to play and not being able to play.
Well, you know, it's not that. It's just avoiding trying to play something bluesy but without it sounding cliche.
No,
you know,
totally. Yeah.
Corny. You know, you're in that area now. We'll be right back.
Yeah, sometimes I'm going to go cliched a little bit and then I'll be going, oh well, never mind.
The first two thirds of that was great. Just can we have a listen to that one?
Yeah, sure.
Just yeah.
The point is, yeah, absolutely for sure, is that it sounds better to me. I mean, it doesn't matter what anybody else thinks. I think it's the analog gear is designed, and a lot of it's older stuff. It was designed by people who were really cared about sound. It really didn't have much to do with making money back then. I mean, Neumann microphones weren't about making money. They were about, let's get something that sounds as real as we can, you know. So they're works of art. Those microphones, those old microphones, the older stuff was, you know, four or five people getting together and trying to work out how to get a better sound up from a tape machine, how to get a better sound from this. Okay, so we didn't use a tape machine, but I've been, you know, using, I spend a lot of money, you know, obviously having a real desk is for me far superior than having, you know, 20 mic pre's and then trying to figure out which one. Let's say that's just for me. So yeah, I think this stuff it's a very good thing to use on the way in, because what you record has to work. To me, it has to work. You put the faders up and it's supposed to work. It's supposed to sound like, start to sound close to the record, you know. Otherwise, you know, the sort of fix it in the mix mentality. It's probably what I used to do when I started, you know. I'm sure I can find a way around it, you know.
I know it's really difficult for you to admit sometimes, Paul, that actually my way might be the right way.
Yeah.
But I appreciate for once that you've managed to swallow your, you know, swallow your pride and admit that I was right just this once.
Actually, so far this is the only time you've been right on the album.
Yeah.
And it's day 16.
Probably not far off from being correct. Right. So I was due wasn't I?
You were due to get something right.
Yeah.
Okay. Might happen again, right?
No, well, based on previous experience, no.
So you must make it from the, yeah, yes. Okay, I was wondering. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. It's loud, fucker. Boy.
It is very loud. You know, as we said, if there was a problem, we'd have to quickly scramble, wouldn't we? If you felt
it's
like...
It's up to you. I'm happy with anything.
It's
a pop piano.
I've used it for 10 years, and I've had nothing but, you know, sort of like occasionally somebody goes, I don't know why I'm playing this, but most people like it. So if you like it, you like it.
I think it'll be fine.
Cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, he's the man. If he feels like he needs to have more of a grand piano sound, something that's going to be different. That's up to you.
For this stuff, I don't think so. The only one that I have a question mark over is Song of Unborn, because it's more of a symphonic sound. But for the rest, because it's like more of a pop record,
right.
I think this is going to be better than the grand piano sound.
Yeah, it'll cut through, but yeah.
action is very light on here. You barely have to play.
So you've been camped out here then for weeks already, huh?
Yeah.
How's it going?
Fantastic. Fantastic.
Well, it's all right, isn't it?
For me, it's fantastic.
It's been a bit hectic.
That sounds great. We've done drums, bass, just started. Nanette was here for a couple of days last week. Just started on guitars.
Yeah, so the guitars that were on the, I don't know what, mostly still demos. Really? Those are just like, is there some nice stuff on there?
There is some that are going to be
kept. We're going to keep, basically now what we're going to do is just keep anything that we love on the demo.
Yeah.
We're just fighting over that at the moment, and then we're just replacing stuff.
This section, I think the piano should be more open and sustaining there.
Oh, okay, because maybe that's because there's no... I thought you wanted it real choppy. There was no foot pedal information on the MIDI file. And I was hearing this choppy thing. I thought, oh man, that must be the pop music vibe.
It's more like Elton John time. You know, it's okay. But we can get that with
the same. Because I actually worked to make it more staccato. My natural instinct was to be... I thought it was like, oh shit, he wants to...
All that stuff.
Okay. I thought you wanted
No, not staccato.
It was actually difficult to do that, so this is easier.
Yeah, nice and open. Nice and open.
The best yet, we reckon.
Yeah.
We'll get it from another take. It's cool.
It's know what? Feel it. Feel it. It almost wants to be like a little kind of a side, not like a big blocky gang, more like a.
Saying anything, are you, Adam?
No.
Cool. Here we go. Waiting for the message. Slow, you know, you're going to off there, don't you?
Yeah,
that's
I know.
Choral,
so. I know, but see, I want to be able to jump from choral to here, but okay, I thought I could do it quicker if I was right here.
Do you want me to do the Leslie, Adam? Because I know exactly where I want it.
Okay, fine. Yeah. That's
should we try one with me?
Put your hand over it so that it doesn't.
As a team.
Still Paul thinks about that. Leslie, too much or?
Then we'll.
Okay, I'll be more confident we find uses for the Selena.
I think the Selena's going to make it. Yeah.
I'd love to see you again soon.
Yeah, there's kind of something like that. I think it's going to be a bit sort of just hit and miss and see what happens and crazy shit going on.
Do you know what I mean? It's slightly middly and hollow, the sound.
Yes.
I wouldn't mind hearing something a little bit more meaty and a bit less middly as a backup to that. We might find a sound and say, oh, you know what, that's much better. We might not, but I'd just like to spend a few minutes exploring a different sound. This is the last thing on this track.
Fucked up the end, but that's a good sound now, I think.
I think the sound is fucking great.
Sounds great.
It's like really vibey, and it's sort of, it's cool because it's not like, it's actually not like Pete Townsend or anybody.
No. Again, please. And again.
Can we get rid of that?
Yes, please.
Something else, which would be like you were in a band improvising and nobody knew the chords properly.
Yeah, that's the sound. That's great. The sound. Great, that's man. Great. I just came in wrong. That's all. I was too excited.
Clue where half the stuff is, so I've been trying to find stuff before this session. It's just drives me insane because there's certain pedals I can't use unless I have the power supply. That is just incredibly annoying. I'm hoping there's one. Even flow, right, I'm good. That's good, right.
What does the blue pedal do?
The
blue pedal.
Yeah.
It's a random looping device. It'll do.
It's a looper.
It's a looper, but it
could be interesting.
It will literally. You'll have to play. You'll play one thing, and it'll do it. It'll either make something happen. These are the sort of make something happen type pedals.
Okay.
I haven't finished plugging in. There's a couple of other things I was going to try and plug in, but
there's a chance to do something quite interesting with looping and stuff at the end of Refuge, I think. Part of it too, though, you know that. Thank you.
I think that's.
So I prefer the other one. But it's up to you.
You prefer the other one?
Yeah, I prefer the one that I did.
Oh,
well,
okay.
We could have the option.
But you can have the option.
Now that we've got the sound poll, let's have one like that too.
Would you mind giving us that option? Because I think that I've got used to that.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, I want to hear your version of that. You know, but I like the syncopation definitely at the start.
Let's have one like that.
Yeah, let's just
do something like
yeah,
that.
Yeah,
that's fucking brilliant. Unfortunately, we actually like that much better. So,
Fred, whatever you like.
So you were wrong.
I don't care.
You, what you played was right. What you said was wrong.
Okay.
Sorry.
No, I mean,
I'm
going
to get another microphone.
So what I do, all, you know, kind of all the time.
Say it.
So what I do all the time.
Really?
But yeah. No, very, you know, like.
But in this context.
It has. Like, dance
music. Oh, it has been. But not in this context, though.
No.
It doesn't sound. I mean, what I'm saying is.
It doesn't sound like.
It doesn't sound like a load of cliches.
No,
it?
No.
No, good. Right. It's just
a great anchor part, a great,
yeah.
You know, kind of swung tumbao, is this.
The original was like a loop, but Logic's, it's in Logic, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
It just sounds great.
Fucking conquered that fucking bit.
Yeah, really good. Awesome.
That's having it.
Love it.
Yep, that's great.
We're done on that one.
Well, the congas are quite dark. You need the tap read really thin light.
Yeah, more information in it.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, fuck me, it's like an Aladdin's cave in here, isn't it?
Well, it is like
it's
an Aladdin's cave.
It's fucking brilliant.
Yeah.
You have to go to the BBC to get as much shit as this.
I don't think there's another studio, and I'd be surprised if another studio in the world that has this stuff.
It's unbelievable.
That has all this stuff, you know.
It's got the old Baker Street desk for a start.
I know. It's like you say to Paul, yeah, have you got like an old like 1960s tape Echoplex? Yeah, I got four of them.
Yeah, it's not one.
It's not one.
No.
So I got four of them. They all sound different.
Yeah, I know.
It's unbelievable, really. Yeah, we've had a lot of fun, actually.
Yeah,
I've really enjoyed it. It's always been fun every day, pretty much.
Yeah, well, you know, when you've got a good vibe, it will come across.
Exactly.
Actually, you know, we were kind of joking about you rummaging through your percussion box.
Yeah.
I almost want it to have that vibe. I don't want it to sound like
a marking sections.
Yeah, I almost want it to feel like there is this kind of random chaotic element to it. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, like you're dropping things and picking things up and. Yeah, I almost want that kind of vibe. Do you know what I mean? Lower in the mix, just nice eerie kind of textures. Yeah. Right, let's do this.
Let's do this stupid fucking shaker shit.
Full stupid idea.
Yeah.
Be able to get this.
I'm not sure if we might have to extend this lead. Yeah, that's better. Cool. I've lost one ear now. Unless I'm going deaf in that right one. Paul, let's just run with it. Go on, go from the front and let's see what we can. Can I have these lights down in here? That's it. I just want a vibe up.
Right.
Just want a vibe up. Yeah.
Yeah.
Good man. What, you want me to play now? Okay, buddy, let's go. Mm.
like the way you kind of fell into the on the verse, the doubling the da 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 da.
Yeah, I wasn't sure the first one.
But that was good. But that was good because it didn't sound planned. It sounded more like you just kind of responded, and that was really nice.
Okay.
But we'll do another one where you maybe
tighten those up.
You know it a bit better. Exactly. But I mean, I may end up preferring that one anyway.
Okay.
Yeah, sounds great.
It's just one mic, is it, Paul? No?
It's just a 67. It's amazing. The old bug standard.
That's fantastic. That's how I hear.
Oh, good.
Cool. Kind of mixed vibe, you know. I'm not the best at the technology side of things. I'm sorry. I was just saying, Steve, that I think that's a tape. I really do. I love that front.
I love it.
Oh
take kind of go, aren't you, Mark?
Yeah,
there you go. Wow. The magic from first takes. Job done, mate.
Job done. Yeah.
Well done.
Nice.
Well done.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Cheers, Mark.
You smell better than me.
Yeah, there you go, bro. Well, well, fresh. Dress is better than you. Fuck's sake.
Oh, that was all right, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. That was a pleasure.
Yeah.
That was a pleasure to listen to you play, mate. 75 quid to find a pop shield.
I mean, I'm old fashioned, so you know, I like older records, and I think older records carry on selling. I think they always seem to be like people are always doing re-releases of, you know, the old classics. And so, is anything that's happened in the last 10 years going to be a classic? Maybe, you know, there'll probably be one or two things, but not like it's not the volume that it was back then. But that's because music has competed out into, like everything, because of computers, everybody's got, you know, everybody can do music.
There's two things for me. Firstly, the definition of someone as an artist is you do it for yourself, you don't do it for other people. So firstly, that's a good enough reason alone to want to make it sound good. It's because an artist basically paints, writes songs, makes music for themselves. Artist is not necessarily an entertainer. The second thing is that there are actually a lot of people out there now. There's a growing audiophile community that love
great
things
sound.
That sound great.
Yeah.
You've got Pure Audio Blu-ray, 9624 resolution. You've got now you can download full resolution files from services like Deezer. I'm not sure about Spotify now, but certainly you can download 9624. And there are people, surround sound. There are people out there that care about that, and they are a minority. They are a substantial minority, and they're growing.
trouble is
it's all pricey shit. It's almost like, if I was picturing it, it's almost like it's late at night and you don't want to wake anybody up. But do you know what I mean?
Great God, I don't believe in you.
Just
great
like, God, yeah.
I don't believe in you.
There you go.
Do you see, that's it. Yeah, here we go. Should we just go in 2 seconds before?
Great God, I don't believe in you, but still I will do what you want me to. Stand up and fight in the city streets. As much I know you expect of me.
Yeah, that was good. Do one more for me.
Yeah.
This time, just go in a little bit on the microphone and sing a little quieter, but get with the same, with your cheeks up or whatever you're doing, okay?
Great God, I don't believe in you, still I will do what you want me to.
Try that one more time, I'm just getting this line. What I like about it is it's more convincing than what you've got, I think.
Yeah. Oh yeah, it is, yeah.
So the distortion isn't covered. The distortion was making it sound like you were covering it up.
Which is exactly what I was doing, yeah.
Well, of course, yeah. And I mean, the thing is, but this actually doesn't, all this is it's distorting in stages, so it's like it's helped a little bit, but it's...
Makes it more edgy without being...
Yeah, well, that was the last take.
Are you trying it? You mean...
Yes, that's good. That's good. Yeah, that's better, I think. And now see it a little bit more, yeah.
Ooh, are you proud of all your failures? Are you dragging Mother Nature down?
Okay, I'll try.
Yeah, that works, I think. So, here we go. Sorry, I'll stop from the beginning.
The other thing is that you can get a fucking good sound to start with.
I think, yeah, that sounds good.
Can be jumped through hoops.
Well, recording is more about performing than anything, so let's. That's where we go.
Let's do it.
Yeah, that's whatever's happened, that's it.
Oh,
sounded very happy.
When I say I'm unproducible, I always kind of, it's always that thing where someone takes you down, your sound down a sort of road that you don't feel comfortable with. And well, I never felt that with you ever, you know.
Well, that's, to me, that's what I rail against, because I just don't think that that's producing. I think that's somebody doing a solo album, you know.
But that's what lots of producers do.
Yeah, they do their own solo album and then kind of manipulate you into doing something that, you know, and I say with artists who don't know what they want, then that's the perfect combination. So it's not like it's bad, it's just that, but for me it's all about working with people who are really good at what they do, really good musicians. I don't want to work with people who can't play ever again. And luckily I haven't had to do that very much. But people who have got a vision themselves, and then what you hopefully can do is say, try this time, you know. But it's not about dominating or manipulating it at all. It's unless they're completely useless anyway, in which case then you can go and do your solo album with somebody else's budget.
But then at the same time, I don't want, and this is another reason why I was keen to change things up, I don't want to make ever the same record twice.
No.
And lots of people do. Lots of artists just keep making the same record.
Yes.
And for me, that's the opposite. I want every record to have a distinct, a reason to exist in the catalogue, you know. And this is a very different record to any I've made before.
This track needs a more electronic vibe.
You know, music business and music don't have an awful lot in common, you know.
That's what I mean.
Not really why. I mean, if you're a musician and you're a really good musician and really good writer, and it's obvious that you've got something that you want to say, then, you know, the advice is, you know, steer clear of that world and do it, you know, buy a computer and, you know, do it yourself, you know, or be around like-minded people and try and find the best quality people that are, you know, that are in the same league as what you think you might be, and work with them, work with the best, you know. I wouldn't
into
the record industry.
No, I mean, I always say now, if you're starting now and you really want to make music, I say do it because you love it. Don't even think about having a career.
Yes.
And if you end up having a career,
it's a bonus.
By accident, great. Yeah. But that's a surefire way to destroy everything that's probably unique and special about what you do or what you can do. And that's the problem for a lot of people, because I think they still think of music as a possible career path. And there's too much music in the world. There's already too many musicians, too much music. You're trying to get into an industry where there's already a surfeit of fodder and music. And the mistake a lot of people make is thinking they have to compromise and fall in line with all that, because it's the worst thing you can do, you know.
Yeah.
You should accentuate what's different about yourself, but that unfortunately that also makes it a lot harder. So I say, don't even think about it as a career. It's just which is a hardened lesson to say to someone that just all they want in life is to be a professional musician.